Yo, how's it going, guys? It's Elite Shot here, aka Sean, and today I just want to show you guys another MOAB in Infected. And here we're playing the Infection or the Knife versus the AA12. And before I start this, I want to say I still have a cold and I'm getting better, so I'm sorry that if I cough in the video or if I have to pause or something, it's because I'm trying to clear my throat. So I'm just saying that in advance. But like I said, we're playing the Knife versus the AA12. And I want to say they've been adding a lot of new game types. They've been changing up this Infected game mode a lot recently in the past few days. They've been adding new game modes like, well, first off, it's all called Knife versus whatever. So it's Knife versus Striker, Knife versus PP90, Knife versus Barrett, Knife versus MSR. They've been changing it a lot, and they also added the FMGs, so the Knife versus Akimbo, and all the Knife versus whatever, they have the throwing knife. And before, the Infections only had the throwing knife when it said T-knife versus whatever. But now it says knife, and that pretty much means they have the tech knife as well as the throwing knife. So every game mode now, they have the throwing knife. And a lot of people might hate this or might like it. I like it personally because now it kind of makes people, or it forces people to run around and not to stay in one corner or camp in one spot. It kind of forces them to run around more. And I'm sorry, my voice is giving out already. But, yeah, like I said, now people have to run around and can't really stay in one spot or on one little ledge. It kind of forces them to run around. And we also have the special strike package. Now we can get perks. And this is only limited to the T-Knife versus whatever. But now, since they added to all the classes or all the game types, now we have specialists in all of them, which is pretty awesome. And the second half of this gameplay, I want to show you guys what people are doing in the Infection game mode. And this is what they were doing before, and now they kind of can't do it anymore because since they added the throwing knife, people can't boost and camp in one spot. But what the guy did was, he and his guest, the guest turned infected while the survivor went ahead and went up these stairs while the guest or the infected blocked the stairs so no one else can get up there and get him. And he was just picking people off through this guy pretty much. And at first, I wasn't realizing what he was doing. I'm like, what the hell's going on here? I wasn't sure what he was doing. But after a little bit, after I realized what he was doing, me and my buddy decided to block both doorways where you see I enter right now. And then there's another door to the left of me. So we pretty much block them so the infections cannot get in. At least any more infections can't get in. So they won't keep dying. And this guy won't keep getting kills because it's stupid. You shouldn't be boosting in an infection game mode. This is meant for fun. This isn't really meant to boost in. I mean, none of the game types are meant to boost in. It's kind of pointless because you're putting yourself at risk to get banned because there is an option when you're in the lobby. If you click on a player's name, then go to report player, and then there's an option that's called boosting. And this is pretty much what it's meant for players doing this, you can report them. So it's definitely not worth it, and there's no point to even boost in this. You don't really unlock anything. Like, there was a Modern Warfare 2, you can unlock the camos. I mean, I guess you can unlock camos faster if you get kills, but I'm sure you can get as many kills as you would if you were doing this as you were if you're playing. And here I'm filing a complaint. Normally I don't file complaints or report players, but this is getting me pretty aggravated because this is so stupid and super pointless. And I'm sorry guys if you're the type of person that boosts or likes to do this kind of thing, but this isn't the game for you if you're just doing this. You're supposed to level up the right way. Excuse me, my voice is giving out like I said. But you should be playing the game the right way and leveling up how everyone else is, and this is definitely not the way to do it. But I'm having a lot of fun playing this new Infected game mode, and I actually kind of like how they're updating it a lot because they're trying to fix it to our needs and our wants, I guess complaints as well. They're fixing a lot of things about this, and hopefully Infection or Infected stays the game mode for quite some time. I hope it stays because I'm having a lot of fun. Since I am 10th Prestige, this is a great way just to have fun in Call of Duty because I'm pretty much done with playing legitly. But as you guys know, they're actually adding 5 more prestiges. I forgot to mention this. They're adding 5 more prestiges. So the max prestige will now be 15th prestige. And I believe they already added this to the PC. But it's coming to the console. Robert Bowling made a tweet himself saying they're increasing the level cap to 15th prestige. And somebody told me that after this, they're going to increase it to 20. But I cannot confirm that. But I know for sure they're increasing it to 15, which is pretty awesome because I'm 10th and I'd love to get to 15th while I'm at it. And playing Infection is a great way to level up because it's a lot of fun, and if you survive and get a lot of kills, you'll definitely get a lot of experience. But I might as well end it here, guys. Nothing much more happens. It's just me and my buddy blocking these guys, and that's about it. But I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.
is almost up.